Good morning, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing a ton of information with you all about different makeup and skincare and cosmetics products. So let's wake ourselves up and get on with it. Before we do anything, I am always freezing, and you guys know that. So I'm taking my favorite coat right here, and I'm going to put this on to keep myself warm. But no, guys, this jacket is not made from animals. It is not made from animal fur. And that is what our video is really gonna be about. What is a vegan makeup product? What is not a vegan makeup product? And here is a little tip right now as we get into our skincare. The green products on the right are not cruelty-free, and the products on the left are cruelty-free. So I'm gonna go through all of this fun stuff with you throughout this whole video about different makeup products, different skincare products that are cruelty-free, that are not cruelty-free, and that are vegan and that aren't vegan, and how to spot one when you are shopping. So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you a bunch of different products, and I'm gonna be using emojis to tell you guys what is cruelty-free, what is vegan, and what is recyclable, and what is none of the above. Some products are a little bit questionable. So as you can see, these two first products that I'm showing you are pretty obvious that they are cruelty-free or recyclable. Now this product right here has no symbols on the back of it. Now that doesn't mean that it's not cruelty-free or vegan or any of the above. Just like this one right here from Derma-E. Derma-E shows a little symbol that it is recyclable, but it doesn't show that it is vegan and cruelty-free, but it is. So you really have to do your research. All right, you guys, so we're starting off with this Lancôme Énergie Levy. This is a cleanser and also a mask. It is not cruelty-free, it is not vegan, and it is not recyclable. So I'm just gonna leave it on for about 5 minutes, and then we are going to just take it right off and move on to the rest of our skincare. Now for this next product right here from Alba Botanica, the company itself is not fully vegan, but it is cruelty-free and it is recyclable, and this product right here is vegan. Now we're going to move on to our serum. This is the Derma-E Purifying Youth Serum. I'm going to apply this all over my face and let it sit before we apply anything else. Then we're moving on to this eye cream from Lancôme. Now it's important to understand that Lancôme is owned by L'Oreal, as many companies are owned by larger companies, and L'Oreal is not vegan, it is not cruelty-free, and it is not necessarily recyclable. Next, I'm using this Painted Earth Boo Boo Gel, and I'm going to put it on all of my problem areas to heal them faster. The next product that I'm using is from Vichy. I'm applying this all over my face to moisturize and help heal my acne. Vichy claims that the materials that compose their products do not harm the biodiversity of the planet, and they also claim that they have never tested their products on even the smallest of animals. This next product I'm using is a lip balm, and it's from a company called Dianis. And if you look at the ingredients on the back, you can see that this product is not vegan because of the use of beeswax and goat's milk. Now to fill in my brows, I'm using the Brow Stylist Pencil from L'Oreal, and this is in the color Dark Brunette. I'm just going to quickly fill those in so that my brows are on fleek. The next product that I'm going to be using is a little bit of a controversial company. This is a product by MAC Cosmetics. I'm using it to prime my eyelids. Now, MAC Cosmetics is owned by Estee Lauder, and they claim that they do not conduct animal testing on any of their products or ingredients, nor ask others to test on their behalf except where it's required by law. Now, MAC and a couple other products owned by Estee Lauder are sold in China, and China requires that products be animal tested. So this next company that I'm using is a company called Tarte Cosmetics. Now, Tarte Cosmetics is known to be vegan and also animal cruelty free. They do voice this very, very often, and all of their products are made with amazing, amazing ingredients. I'm not sure if they are recyclable, but I believe that they are making steps to be recyclable. The next product is Anastasia Beverly Hills. Now, Anastasia Beverly Hills is cruelty-free, but not all of their products are vegan. I don't believe this is one of the products that is vegan that I'm using right now, but I will leave a bunch of links down below that you guys could check out. So now I'm going to take this darker shade from the Tarte Clay Palette, and I'm just going to blend that on the inner and outer corners, and then also in the crease of my eye. The next palette I'm going to be taking is from Juvia's Place, and I'm going to be applying this in the inner and outer corners. And back to the clay palette, we're going to apply this in the inner and outer corners too to give it some more darkness. Then we're going to move on to this BH Cosmetics Carly by Belle palette. Now, this palette right here is vegan and it is animal cruelty free, and I just want to show you this swatch right here. See, even animal cruelty-free and vegan products can be amazing too. So I'm gonna show you what I'm using for my lashes and my mascara. This is the Too Faced mascara. I actually did not use these cocoa lashes as my lashes. I used another company called House of Lashes. Not positive if they are cruelty-free, but I believe they are. Then we're using another product from Too Faced and a product from Milk Makeup. Both of these are cruelty-free, vegan, and Milk Makeup is 100% recyclable. For the foundation, I'm using the NARS All Day Luminous, and the color that I use is called Barcelona. Alright, so moving on to the concealer, I'm just using a Tarte concealer, and my color is light medium, and then blending that out with a beauty blender. Then for my powder, I'm using the Cover FX setting powder. This is their perfect setting powder, and using the beauty blender as well. And then a powder brush on the rest of my face. We're jumping back into that amazing clay palette, and I'm just bronzing up my face with one of the bronzers and a big, big fluffy brush. And then I use the clay palette shadows to just bring together the underneath. So now we're moving on to Milani Cosmetics. This is a drugstore brand that is vegan and cruelty-free. And now Jouer Cosmetics for my highlighter, which is definitely cruelty-free, but I'm not sure on the vegan or if it's recyclable. I also took that highlighter in Citrine and I applied it to my brow bone and also the inner corners. Now we're moving on to lips. Now, something special about the lips, I'm using yet another MAC product, and I wanted to mention that MAC may not be cruelty-free or vegan, but it is and always has been, for the most part, recyclable. So what they do is they have a special program where you can recycle up to, I believe, 5 products or 6 products, and you get a free lipstick. So they encourage recycling, definitely. As for the lipstick I'm using from Bite Beauty, I believe this is in the color Lychee. They are cruelty-free, but they are not vegan. They do use animal byproducts in their lipsticks, and I'm not sure if they are recyclable. It's pretty hard to find if products are recyclable or not. But here is the MAC lip liner. Again, I'm just kind of ombreing that out a bit, and we're gonna move on to some gloss. Buxom themselves are cruelty-free, but the company that owns them is not. It seems to be a trending thing with a lot of brands. Lastly, I'm using a Pixi Makeup Fixing Mist, and that completes this look. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and found it really informational. Please forgive me if the information is not fully 110% correct, but I tried to find all of the information that I could. Comment down below if you've tried out any of these products or if you love any vegan, cruelty-free, or recyclable products. Leave them down below and maybe I'll make more videos like these. But thanks guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, thumbs up this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!